bobsleigh is not a roller coaster. There's this misconception that it's all about the push start. It's all about how fast you can get the sled going down there. And that once you're going downhill, it's mostly just aerodynamics and good luck. You hold on and you hope. Well, for the tourists going down there in self-steering little taxi bob capsules, sure, but this is something different. This is the monobob, and it's a new event for the 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games.
Monobob is a new concept devised by the IBSF, the International Skeleton Bobsleigh Federation. It's a form of bobsleigh where one person drives the sled and becomes a boatman at the same time. So you get all aspects of the sport. You push and you drive and you brake.
To drive a monobob, it's not a complicated system, it's quite basic. There's two things called D-rings, which are inside the sled and we hold on to them, and they're attached to the front runners. So if we want to turn right, we pull the right one and it turns the runners to the right, and the same for going left. So it's literally just a pull system and it turns the runners, so it's quite basic. It is hard to find a perfect racing line, especially when you're driving the track, because every run can be slightly different. You can enter and exit corners slightly differently. So you have to be able to adapt and find the best line for that run.
Monobob is not a roller coaster. It's a very adrenaline rush sport. You get the same adrenaline rush as you do on a roller coaster. However, you're in control of what you're doing.
Every monobob used in the games is identical. No technology advantages here. It is all about the pilot and the physics. Steer higher and you'll go faster, but there's more distance to cover. Steer low and you will take the shortest route, but you won't be as fast. There is a perfect racing line to follow, like in any speed sport, a perfect balance between the two. That doesn't mean that the start isn't important though, it's vital.
The start in bobsleigh, well, and in monobob, in any sliding sport really, is so important because it's roughly about for 1/10 at the top of the track that you're faster. You can gain 3/10 at the bottom, providing the drive has been okay. So it's so important that you can win and lose a race based on just the start, and that's the first 30 metres of a track, which can be over a kilometre long.
You can start faster than anybody else. As a driver, that allows you to make the mistakes down the track, so you don't need the perfect run. So having a faster start allows you to be more relaxed in the sled, so that if you do make a mistake or take a tap on the wall, you know that you still have the advantage of time from the start, so it helps you relax more in the sled.
Monobob athletes need to have the same qualities as track and field sprinters, but they also need to be able to push 160 kilos of sled down this push start track. Oh, and they also need to be able to withstand 4 or 5 Gs at the bottom on the curves.
So there's a lot of similarities between monobob and track and field athletes, like particularly like sprinting events like that, because of the start. Quite often athletes who have been sprinters or even something like a long jumper will have that speed and power from training like that, that they can then transfer to bobsleigh. Bobsleigh is a sport that can be decided on hundredths of seconds, so you need every help that you can get to be faster, you need it.
There's a load more videos over on the Olympics channel and on my channel. Go check them out, go subscribe, and thank you to the Youth Winter Olympic Games for bringing me out here to Lillehammer.